When I buy my personal rig, gusto ko top of the line siya, tapos di ko na siya babaguhin for the next 4 or 5 years. So malaki yung upfront cost, pero wala ka nang babaguhin, wala ka nang gagastusin after that. My current PC is almost 6 years old, i5-4690K, nabili ko June 2015. Tapos actually yung processor na yun, lumabas siya 2014. Yung graphics cards ko, RX470s na naka-crossfire, second hand pa sila. And my motherboard only supports DDR3 RAM na mga 2133MHz lang ata yung speed. Di na monster yung rig ko. Medyo mabagal na siya, medyo matanda na siya. But, you know, I like playing games and I wanna see them in all their high-res graphics glory. So naisip ko, can I make my rig a monster again kung palitan ko lang yung isang part? And we're gonna find out after an annoying ad from us.
Ang video na to ay handog ni cdkoffers.com. Marami kang mahahanap na iba't ibang uri ng software dito. May games, apps, activation codes for Windows 10. Check out our video on CDK Offers in the video description. Mabilis, mura, and syempre legit dito. Madali lang mag-order, search for the software you need, add to cart, check out, daan ka sa payment options nila, wala pa isang minuto, finished. May legit working CDK ka na sa software na pinili mo. Gamitin ang aming promo code para makakuha pa ng extra 20% discount sa purchase mo. Kung naghahanap ka ng mura, legit, and original software, check out cdkoffers.com.
So the situation is, I'm still happy actually with my computer. Yun nga, yung mga AAA games ngayon, medyo bumibigay na siya. And I like playing them at high res. So naisip ko, palitan kaya natin yung graphics card. Graphics card lang. I won't change anything else, I won't buy anything else. And thank you to Asus for lending us a top-of-the-line card, the TUF 3080 OC. So papasok ko to si TUF 3080 OC dun sa luma kong rig. And then, tingnan natin, kamusta ba yung performance? Will changing one part let you play AAA games in all of their high-res graphic gory glory? Just an explanation on why I want to do this experiment. Usually, after your PC is around 4 or 5 years old, yun nga, magsi-6 na yun sa akin, iniisip mo na ang hirap na mag-upgrade kasi ang dami na nagbago, ang dami ng mga bagong hardware na mas mabilis. Hindi lang naman RGB habol ko kung bibili ako ng bagong PC, but it's impossible for me to get the latest and the greatest kasi let's say yung sa MOBO, yung socket, iba na siya. And probably I would want to go Ryzen if I were to get a new CPU. So a new CPU, kailangan ng bagong motherboard, kailangan mo ng bagong RAM. Siguro you can save the storage and you can reuse the power supply. But I would need a new case kasi sira-sira na rin case ko. And that's the point. After 4 or 5 years, you're faced with this choice na kung mag-upgrade ako, kailangan ko na kasi palitan lahat ng mga important parts, yung mga mahal na parts. Kaya naisip ko tong experiment na to na palitan lang natin yung graphics card. Total, yung GPU naman yung pinakamahalaga na part for gaming. Okay pa naman ako sa ibang performance niya sa web surfing, downloading, kahit yung streaming, sobrang okay pa siya. Renderings for video editing, okay pa siya. It's just in gaming na medyo nakulangan na ako. So can I get away with replacing it with the TUF 3080 OC, which is one of the top of the line cards now? And definitely, there are cons to this approach. Number one, and ito talaga, I'm sure napakamot na yung ibang mga PC guys watching this, is syempre yung bottlenecks. Ba't mo gagawin yun sa 3080? Yung TUF 3080 OC, sobrang bilis na graphics card, pero hindi siya makatakbo at its full speed. Kasi hinihintay niya yung instructions galing sa CPU na medyo mabagal na kasi thunders na si CPU. And ito yung tinatawag na bottleneck. You don't enjoy the full performance of your graphics card because it's stuck waiting for instructions from the CPU. And no doubt, magbabottleneck talaga to. And please don't flame me in the comments, I know magbabottleneck siya. Pero gusto ko lang makita na kahit may bottleneck, sapat na ba yung performance para maka-enjoy ako nung high-res gaming, nung AAA games? Number two con, since I'm only changing the GPU, ang dami pang mga improvements sa PC na hindi related sa graphics card. And hindi ko ma-enjoy yon kasi hindi na compatible yung hardware ko. For example, DDR5 RAM, NVMe SSD. Lahat yon hindi ko mabili, hindi ko ma-upgrade kasi hindi sila compatible sa motherboard ko. PCIe 4 is another new improvement na nabibilis yung transfer rates between your different devices like the GPU and the CPU and the SSDs. And that's another thing I can't enjoy because my motherboard doesn't support that. So you're missing out on a lot of the new hardware out there kung yung GPU lang palitan mo. And that's true, that's a downside to this approach. But there are also positives or may pros naman sa approach na to kung palitan mo lang yung graphics card. Number one is pinapalitan mo lang yung graphics card. So mahal nga yung 3080 OC. I mean, mahal siya compared to the other cards out there. Pero yun nga, kasi top of the line siya. Tapos yung gastos mo lang is to replace the card. You don't need budget to replace your CPU, your MOBO, your RAM. You're only spending for the graphics card. And so you can actually spend more money. Imbis na 3070, 3060 Ti lang bilhin mo, since may extra budget ka na, na you saved because you didn't need to buy a new CPU, new MOBO, etc., you can get a nicer card, such as the tough 3080 OC. Number two pro is that sobrang dali lang palitan yung GPU. It's one of those items na tagalin mo yung lumang mong drivers, pasok mo yung bagong GPU, pasok mo yung bagong drivers, everything will still be okay. Hindi siya kasing messy na palitan mo yung CPU, palitan mo yung CPU cooler mo. If you're buying a modern CPU, you might be tempted to go AIO, so that's another expense. And if you change your motherboard, malamang magre-reklamo si Windows, akala niya na bagong rig talaga siya, so it will ask for a new activation key. Most likely, actually, if you're buying a new rig, you might as well just get a new version of Windows. So maglilipat ka pa ng mga files mo galing sa luma mong Windows 10 to the new Windows 10. There are a lot of hassles, complications, headaches involved in buying a completely new rig. Yung kagandahan, kung palitan mo lang yung GPU, sobrang simple lang nun. Tagalin mo si luma, pasok mo yung bago, game. And the number three pro is that ang dami ko na-mention ng mga bagong stuff, pero actually, hindi lahat yun nakakatulong sa gaming performance. For example, yung PCIe 4, which is supposed to have faster transfer rates. And automatically, you think, mas maganda siguro si PCIe 4 kasi siya yung pinaka-latest, si PCIe 3 yung previous generation. Mas mabilis naman yung transfer rates on paper. Pero actually, may nag-test na nung mga PCIe 4 and this was actually last year. You can check it out on Gamers Nexus or, you know, those hardcore benchmarking sites like that. Sobrang konti lang ng performance increase ni PCIe 4. Yes, sometimes there is a performance increase, but in the real world, will you notice that extra 1 or 2 frames per second? Siyempre, yung mga manufacturers, gustong-gusto nila yan. PCIe 4, bago na yan, luma na sa PCIe 3. DDR5, bago na yan, luma na si DDR4. And yet, for a lot of these improvements, you don't really feel the speed. On paper, yes, mas mabilis nga sila. Pero in actual real-world conditions, konti lang yung performance increase and it's imperceptible to the user. So you're actually saving your money by resisting the hype and not upgrading to, yes, baka nga mas mabilis siya, 2 frames per second faster. But do you really need an entirely new computer para lang maka-enjoy ka nung an additional 2 frames per second? So there are some pros to considering this approach na lumang PC, palitan lang natin yung graphics card. So tama na daldal, how did it do? For primary testing, we chose Cyberpunk 2077 because it's supposed to be a AAA game and a lot of people have complained na nababagalan sila sa rig nila when they play Cyberpunk. So this was a perfect test game for us kasi bagong labas, luma na PC ko, definitely kung gamit ko pa rin yung luma kong graphics cards, mahihirapan rin ako sa kanya and I wouldn't be able to play it at max settings. But with the tough 3080 OC, I was able to play it on full everything. Full 2K resolution, yung pinaka-maximum nung in-game native resolution niya. Ultra graphic settings, everything. All of the graphic settings, sinubukan ko na ipasok sa pinaka-ultra high performance nila. And the game is very playable, even though I am using an i5-4690K. Totoo nga naman, kita sa benchmarks na sobrang bottleneck talaga siya. Usually, 100% load talaga yung CPU ko, yung GPU ko, hindi 100%. Naghihintay ng instructions from the GPU. But from a gameplay perspective, I saw the best that the game engine could render. Ultra-high settings, 2K, the maximum. And it was very playable. On the average, what I could see from within the city with a very crowded scenery, I would be getting around 35 to 45 FPS. Indoors, in an action setting, so indoors, isolated, contained environments but with a lot of enemies, so still a lot of moving characters, I would see around frames of 55 to 60 FPS. Which makes sense because the engine has less things to worry about when you're indoors, it's isolated, it doesn't need to render a lot of things compared to outdoor settings where it has to draw the entire city, especially when the character looks out onto the horizon. So definitely, if you had a much nicer system, you can get much higher frame rates. But 40, 45 FPS outdoors, 55 FPS indoors is still very playable considering that the graphics were on ultra everything. The game did stutter noticeably when you scope in on a sight or you zoom in on the gun barrel when you're in a crowded situation. Noticeable stutter there. Noticeable stutter also when you hop on a vehicle and then you have it on third-party perspective. So you're seeing more of the scenery in third-party. Noticeable stutter when you hop on the vehicle. Noticeable stutter also while driving. Again, because the game engine is struggling to render everything. Rather, your system and my poor six-year-old CPU is struggling to instruct the GPU on what to render in such a crowded setting, especially when you're driving. So definitely, there were moments that were very reproducible na hindi talaga nakayanan ng lumang system ko and nag-stutter siya. But action sequences were very fluid. When I died, it was my fault and not because I couldn't maneuver in time kasi nagsa-stutter yung game. And just from a quality perspective, I was able to enjoy Cyberpunk. Hindi ko naisip na hindi ko ma-appreciate tong game na to, yung kwento na to, because ang bagal nung PC ko. At the end of the day, I played it for more than 40 hours and hindi siya sakripisyo. I mean, hindi siya yung parang grabe, parang I want to see how this game goes, so I'm gonna play it even though sobrang bagal, even though sobrang jittery. And yun nga, I've been able to play it on ultra settings and with very decent frame rates.
If the 3080 OC can power my old ass rig to ultra settings at decent frames in Cyberpunk 2077, then it's no surprise it can easily do over 144Hz in less demanding games like Valorant. This is actually my first time playing Valorant, and the silky smooth frame rate certainly helped my rusty reflexes pick up a kill or two.
Bang!
No charges left. One enemy remaining. Last. One dead.
So at the end of the day, would I recommend this upgrade approach? Yes, but not to everyone. Yung mga purists, yung mga gusto talaga yung pinakamabilis at yung talagang pinipigan nila lahat ng frames per second, ng performance, ng anong kaya ng computer nila, this approach would not be good for them. If you want to get the most performance out of your parts, then definitely naka-handicap or naka-bottleneck yung GPU if you put it in a very old system. And there are some people, and legit concern naman to na nahihinayang sila. It's like bumili ka ng mabilis na kotse, pero yung takbo mo lang 30, 40 kilometers per hour. Eh, bumili ka ng Porsche, bumili ka ng BM, kaya yan 150, 200. It's like you bought a nice sports car, pero iniikot mo lang sa EDSA, imbis na dapat pinapatakbo mo yan sa autobahn. And that is a legitimate criticism of this approach. If bottlenecking bothers you, if you're the type na sobrang optimized ng system, then definitely this approach is not for you. If you have an old system that you're still happy with, like myself, but at the same time, you just need to play the occasional AAA game. Kasi aminin ko sa'yo, hindi naman ako ganun na super gamer. I mean, I'd love to be, but there are so many games I'd love to play, but not all of them are AAA. Actually, a lot of them are indie games na hindi naman kailangan ng sobrang bilis na computer. And even if I wanted to play all of the AAA games, ang daming adulting na kailangan gawin. Kailangan patakbo si Hardware Sugar, kailangan ko gumawa ng videos for YouTube, and there's so many other things, personal and professional, that I need to do that cut into my AAA game playing time. So nahihinayang ako bumili ng bagong computer kasi iniisip ko, di ko rin naman siya ma-enjoy fully. Right now, I'm happy with my setup. It does what I need it to do. And if I want to play AAA games, then changing the graphics card does that for me. Tapos yung maganda pa dito, since top of the line naman yung graphics card, I can use this as an extender. Bilin ko to, I'm happy with it for the next 1 year. Next year, baka bumili na ako ng bagong system, sobrang okay pa rin yung tough 3080 OC or any of the higher-end graphics cards nowadays. they will still be very good 1 year from now. So kumbaga, na-enjoy mo na yung graphics card ngayon, you're able to play AAA games at ultra high res, you didn't need to spend to buy a whole new computer. Tapos next year, pag comfortable ka na, pag ready ka na bumili ng bagong computer, pwede mo pa naman gamitin itong top-of-the-line GPU. So I can see some people, such as myself, na bibili nung top-of-the-line graphics card, pasok natin sa lumang war machine natin, and let's see the old girl ride again. Thanks for watching.
And thank you to our top fans, Asher Gabe Anima Mundi, Mark Anthony Palanya, Christian Espinosa, John Ruben Ocha, D. Prishon, ITX Addict. Your support literally makes the channel possible, and for everyone else, please keep watching those ads. Thanks and stay safe.